Hey guys, welcome back to the Zethythonix channel. Today I'm going to be reviewing the Gundam G04. The Gundam G04 to myself is like my childhood because when I was a little kid, I played a game called SD G Generation World. There is a mission, I think it's G04 and G05 is your enemy, and they will be moving together. They will be attacking you together, and whenever there's a cutscene where they're attacking you, the G05 will use the giant Gatling gun shooting at you, and then the camera zooms down, and then the G04 will use the launcher to attack you, which was why I remember it very clearly. I'm glad that Bandai actually finally gave us a G04 model. I know there's a Master Grade, but to myself, when I was a little kid, I don't dig into Master Grade, and I actually don't know that. Back in like 2007 or 2006, Master Grade already released the G04 and G05 combo, but until now, we finally got a XG version of the G04. Personally, I'm pretty excited on building this G04, but last time for the unboxing video, I opened up the G04 box and I saw a lot of sticker in it, and somehow it just kind of washed away my excitement. I still love the G04, but I assume there's going to be a lot of recoloring required. So right now the box art is the G04 shooting at the enemy. I think this pose is exactly the same like the SDG Generation World. And for the side right here, we got the storyline of the Mobile Suit Gundam side story Space to the End of the Flash. It's a PS2 game. I never played it, and if you played it, please tell me down in the comments. And at the other side, as usual, is nothing. So how about we just open up the runners first? Now let's start with the instruction menu, but I always said it like this. I really hate the XG Premium Bandai instruction menu. They didn't even give you the pictures. Like, it's just so boring. Like, take a look at the RG and the MG ones. The Premium Bandai, they still have pictures. And for the high grade, they didn't even give you like picture or any kind of weapon explanation or anything like that. So, you know, Bandai, I will keep saying this. Please make some pictures for the Premium Bandai instruction menu. Anyway, so the G04 features normal mode and the BST form. And let's take a look quickly. Okay. So the backpack and the shoulders can switch between normal mode and BST form. And this is the shield, large piece of stickers. Okay. And then we got some markings as well. That's it. Starting with the G-Runner. This G-Runner came from the Power Rider Space Combat type, I think it's from. And it's the shield and the backpack filled tanks, I think. This is why there's a lot of stickers, because this shield right here, they just directly stole it from the Power Rider, I think. And then it's just plain white. And all the colors of the shield will be stickers. I assume it's not gonna look good. We got the H-Runner, is from the Power Rider Space Combat type again. We got the Rival, and the rest of it is just a scope, and then this is the backpack as well. We got the C1 and C2 Runner. The C1 Runner came from the Mud Rock Gundam. These are all the inner frames and hands option. We got a D1 and D2 Runner. They are for the Gundam G04, and you can see some inner frame of the torso, some hands option right here, and then you can see some like shoulders part right here. I'm not sure these two though. We got B1 and B2 Runner, and then you can see some feet part, some kind of skirt armor, and then you can see the launcher parts, and then this one right here, I'm not sure which part is these, and this one right here, I think it's the waist, I think, and these parts right here, I'm not really sure. Maybe this one right here is the torso parts. We got the E1 and E2 parts. We can see antennas, scopes, and then some part of the chest as well. The rest of it, I'm not really sure. We got the A1 and A2 Runner. They are for the outside armor. You can see some legs part, launchers, and then you can see the backpack part. Is this a backpack part? Yes. And then we can see the feet. We can also see some waist part right here, and then some legs and arms, and then we can see the Gundam head as well. Polycaps, markings, a wire for the launcher, beam saber effect parts, and the only thing that I really want to complain, large piece of stickers. You see, there's a lot of stickers required for this kit, so if you don't like big stickers, man, I gotta tell you, you're gonna need to do a lot of recolor. Okay guys, I'm gonna start building and I'll see you at the review.
Hey guys, welcome back to the review of the HGUC Gundam G04, so this is the finishing of it. So compared to the G06 Mud Rock Gundam last time, I felt like that G04 is a little bit disappointing. Yes, the colors still look good, yes, the articulation is pretty nice, but there's a lot of parts required A, repaint, or B, stickers. And I saw some part that meant I could just easily cut out another piece to achieve that color separation, but yet they refused to do so. So it's very awkward for me to actually rate the G04 with the excitement that I have for the Mud Rock Gundam, because considering the fact that there's a lot of small details you need to repaint, but I can't forgive that because I know XG is so small, you cannot just, you know, add another part to those small part right there to achieve this very minor color separation. But the part I'm talking about is some of the parts on this Gamma right here, they could have just easily cut out another piece and then they just shove it in and then done. You don't have to repaint anything. But yet, Bandai didn't do it. I will talk about those parts later. So I'm going to stop talking now and actually get into the review. For stickers of this kit right here, so first the eyes, the sensor, and then the front waist right here, the legs part right here, and this gray part on the feet as well, these will be the stickers. And also, you know, the sensor of the Mega Beam Launcher, and also the yellow part of the Beam Rival will be stickers as well. For the repainting part, there's a lot, such as the back of the feet right here, supposed to be gray. Again, we got gray runner in the kit, so I don't understand why Bandai could have just cut out another piece to achieve that color separation, but they didn't do it, so I don't really understand why. And for this part right here, so this part, actually this part is supposed to be blue, but we got a blue runner inside the kit, and I don't know why they can't just give us another color separation. And then for the small thrusters, like this circle and the squares right here, well, actually the rectangles, you need yellow. And then for the back skirt right here, you will see two squares right here, the white squares. They are supposed to be gray, but you did the color for the front skirt, but you refused to do the color of the back skirt. It's really weird, actually. For the beam sabers, the middle of the beam saber is supposed to be white. For the backpack, thrusters supposed to be yellow. And then we also got some... Wait, actually, all of them is yellow. Now, turn it to the front right here. These kind of small thrusters right here are supposed to be yellow again. And then for the shoulders, these kind of thrusters right here are supposed to be yellow, but once you put on the BST armor, you can't see it anyway, so it's good to not repaint it. For further stickers and repainting of the accessories, I'll just leave it to the accessories part because I just don't want to spoil everything. So for the head right here, it's actually kind of, I don't know how to say it, awkward, funny, but the part is, the side of the head right here, you will see yellow pieces, and these kind of yellow pieces are by parts, but yet Bandai cannot mold another one for the backpack thrusters. It's actually quite confusing about the logic here. So it's just a part that personally, it's kind of confused for myself. So first move up, move down, and then moving 360 is possible as well. So it's just a very standard poly cap joint right here. So the movement is just gonna be like this. Now let's take a look at the chest right here. The chest, as I mentioned, there's part that you need to repaint, but I'm glad that they actually gave us the frosted color right here, so we don't have to furthermore repaint it. So for the articulation of the chest, it's quite simple. It's ball joint, so 45 degrees will be the max. For the arms articulation, so first 360, you can also move the whole arm to the front. And then for the rotation of the arms right here, the forearm and the whole arm can rotate as well. So you can make the pose more natural, and the bending will be touching the shoulders. Very nice because, you know, it's using the same frame as the Mud Rock Gundam, so obviously the articulation is not going to be too bad. For the shoulders part right here, we got this part that is movable as well, and we can also extend this part as well. This two parts right here is for you to put on the BST armor later. Oh, and I also forgot to mention the whole arm can lift up 90 degrees very easily as well. Now, let's take a look at the waist right here. So the front waist right here can lift up. I cut them so they can move individually. And for the front skirt right here, I just really want to appreciate that Bandai actually gave you the part as well. The yellow and the gray part right here, all by parts, no stickers. And they can't do it for the back skirt. Great. So for the side skirt right here, we can lift up, and then that's pretty much it. And for the back skirt, as usual, XG not movable. Let's take a look at the legs articulation. So first, kicking to the front, 90 degrees, kicking to the back. Nope, the back skirt is not movable, kicking to the side. Sort of 90 degrees, but the side skirt actually bumping into the legs, so the articulation is gonna get affected. And also for the bending though, perfect U-shape. Wow, so satisfying. And then for the feet down here, you can adjust the position front and back. And it's a ball joint as well, so you can move 360. This white piece of armor right here, you can move as well. And one thing that I want to talk about as well, when you turn to the bottom of the feet right here, you will see some extra details. For the backpack part, 50% is from the G04 and 50% is from the Power Rider Space Combat type. That's the one thing that I want to tell you. And for the backpack, as usual, two beam sabers and then a lot of thrusters that you need to repaint. But this backpack compared to the original RX-78, I actually quite like this backpack because not only the backpack, there's some extra things on the backpack. So it kind of don't look that boring. These four parts right here are for the BST form. So for the BST form, it is literally adding extra armor on the shoulders and then two fuel tanks. That's it. And then for the fuel tanks though, it's from the Power Rider Runner again, so of course it's going to be repainting. These kind of small parts right here will be yellow. So again, small parts you need to repaint. For the shoulders, it's quite easy. Just grab a Gundam marker and then just put in some black inside the thrusters and that will be it. For the BST form, it's pretty simple. First, you add extra fuel tanks onto the backpack like this, very simple. For the shoulders, open the extra armor and then just put in the extra parts of the shoulders. And that will be it. Let's go through the accessories. So first, we got a pair of beam saber. I curved one of them so I can shoot the photos. We got a trigger hand and beam rifle. So for the beam rifle, again, is from the Power Rider Runner, which is why the scope cannot be color separated. It's a sticker. And for the scope, you can move 180, and then you can also move the sub-handle as well. Upcoming next is the shield right here. This shield is directly from the Power Rider Runner, so all the blue parts that you're seeing right now is all stickers. I just really don't understand why Bandai can't just give us two extra blue parts to give us that color separation. You got blue runners inside the kit, mate. To put on the shield is actually quite simple. Just find a spot on the forearm and then plug it in, and this will be how you put on the shield. Welcome to the signature weapon of the G04, Mega Beam Launcher. So is a wire, wet wire, and then this is the battery pack, and this is the Mega Launcher itself. So at the side right here, you'll see some cables right here. These will be repainting parts. You need to repaint it to red. I really want to say that I love the appearance of this Mega Beam Launcher right here. Also, by the way, the sub handle, you can move it as well. So you can hold it with both hands. Like this. To put the Mega Beam Launcher onto the backpack, first you need to separate the backpack and then put the battery packs at the left side of the backpack and then move the line under the backpack right here. And then there's a place for you to plug in the Mega Launcher like this. So you should have something like this. So this is what it looks like after you put on the Mega Launcher to the G04. Alright guys, this will be the end of the review. Thank you guys for watching this Gundam G04 review. So the Gundam G04 is quite awkward actually. Master Grey is too old. And for the High Grey version, is too expensive. And it's also almost as expensive as the Master Grey. So for the fans that you want to buy the Gundam G04, I think you should do some research and actually make a decision about whether you want to purchase the Master Grade version or the High Grade version. The Master Grade version, unfortunately, I don't own it, so I can't really give you that much advice. But based on the research that I read and watched, the Master Grade G04 is not that bad. The articulation is acceptable, and also the colors is actually quite nice. So for the kit from 2006 or 2007, the Master Grade Gundam G04 is quite solid. So maybe my personal advice will be like this. If you don't want to repaint and you want to go for the cheapest and easiest option, I think Master Grade will be the best. And if you're someone who only likes to collect small scale, buddy, let's just say like this, I already warned you that you need to pay a little bit more for the HG version because it's the premium Bandai version. So again, before buying the Gundam G04, let's do a little bit of research about the Master Grade and the High Grade version. Thanks for coming to my tech talk. And thank you guys for watching this video. If you like this video, subscribe and hit the bell next to the subscribe button so you get notified whenever I upload a new video.
Donation links is in the description, and I will see you in the next review. Goodbye! Well done to those of you that still haven't closed the video, because I just want to show you my heavy arms. Well, I rushed the waterside decals in one night, which was why I'm able to show you in this review. Thank you guys for giving me 1k views for the first day of my heavy arms review. So this is basically the finish of the waterside decals. You can see that this is why decals is very important to a Gunpla model, because it just upgraded the finish so much. Like, take a look at this. So I'm being very extra careful, but I still want to say it like this. Even though you put on protection coat, it's ideal for you to use gloves to touch the Gunpla with waterside decals, because you try to protect the waterside decal from falling off, peeling off, or scratch and damage. So let's just say it like this. If your Gunpla put on the waterside decal, you should never touch it again or play with it again.